Okay, we're going to start part three of making the ball bounce. And one of the things that we're going to do is we're simply going to learn about putting exposure into the art, putting keyframes in, and tweening it in this part. So, what does exposure mean? Exposure is basically, you can notice that I only have one frame exposed, and when I go to frame two, the ball simply disappears. So I need to make this exposure the length of the scene. So I'm going to go back to the last frame of the scene. I'm going to right click, and I'm going to say extend exposure. And we can see the hotkey is F5. And now we have the ball being shown for the length of the scene. Now, when I animate, I like to keep the timeline closed. You can see that we have a peg layer here and a ball layer here. I want to close those up. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to just plan out the timing of my scene. So, on frame one, I'm going to put a keyframe. On frame maybe 15, I'm going to put a keyframe. And on frame 31, I'm going to put a keyframe. And what I've done is I've basically just put keyframes on odd numbers. The reason I like to use odd numbers is when I tween it and put the rest of the scene on twos, everything will be on odd numbers on the timeline. So let's quickly take frame two. We're going to drag that down to the bottom of the scene. And we're going to go to frame three, and we have just three simple positions already added. Now the last thing that we're going to do in this part three is tween. I'm going to highlight all of my frames, and I'm going to press this button. And if you've done it right, when you go to your playback, the ball will go up and down. Now right now it's kind of a stiff bouncing ball, but we're going to add timing and squash and stretch in part four.